Okie dokie, how about a quick math moment? All right, real quick. Had some folks struggling with the idea of dependent and independent probability, how to calculate them. Let's just do the examples in the puzzle we did. Next slide. Okay, read and do. Read and do. Pause this. Are you set to go? Let's give her. All right, what's the probability that when you spin this spinner and this spinner, notice it's two separate spinners, they are independent. What happens on one spinner has nothing to do with what happens on the next spinner. The outcome of this spinner does not influence the outcome of this spinner. They are completely independent events they generate. And the secret formula for doing that is you just multiply their two events together. All right, so what's the probability you'll spin a blue on this spinner and A on this spinner? All right, so let's just do it using the probability method. So the probability of a blue and an A on the other spinner is you're going to take the probability of the blue and multiply it by the probability of the A. That's a pretty complicated formula. You might want to write this one down, right? Or maybe not. There's the formula right there. So it's going to be 1 out of 5. There's 5 sectors there. Only one of them is blue. And there's 3 sectors there. Only one of them is A. So 1 over 5 times 1 over 3, straight across the top, straight across the bottom. But if you don't know how to do fractions, just use your calculator. I don't care anymore. All right, let's do alpha here. What's the probability that when you spin this spinner, you get a not red? And when you spin this spinner, you get an A? Well, let's combine the two probabilities. What's the probability you'll get a not red and you'll get an A? So we'll combine the two. It's pretty easy to combine independent events. You just multiply their probabilities. So the probability that you're not red. Well, let's see. There's 5 sectors. 3 of them are not red. So 3 of them are not red. See, not over top. So it's going to be, what's that, 3 out of 5 times, let's see, how many of them are A on the second spinner? 1 out of 3. And do a little canceling, bing, bing, looks like 1 out of 5. So the answer is 1 out of 5. Use your calculator, your ABC button, if you don't know that that's the same as 1 out of 5. All right, so that's pretty. Let's try echo here. The probability that it's red on the first spinner and it's an A on the second spinner. All right, let's just do that. I think I'll let these go on their own. All right, so this was a puzzle you had. So the probability that it's red and the second spinner is an A. All right, so I'm thinking there's 2 reds. Notice I've left out the formulas now. After a while, you can start to leave out the entire formula, but you certainly want to start the very first dozen times you do these. You probably want to write out the full formula, otherwise you'll lose track of what you're doing. The probability of a red is 2 out of 5. The probability of an A is 1 out of 3. 2 fifths times 1 third looks like about 2 fifteenths to me. All right, so these are all pretty easy. I'll just accelerate. This is too boring. You ready? You can copy them down. So those were all pretty easy. Just copy them down. This was one of your assignments. This was one of the puzzles. I love those puzzles. Excellent. Okay, now what happens if you have dependent events? Dependent means one event affects the next event. All right, so check it out. Here's the letters in the word Arkansas. And you're supposed to find the probability if you pick a card. It doesn't mean pick all 3 of one of the letters. It says pick a single card. Do not replace it. That's different than the first slide, right? The first page, you were putting things back. Well, the first slide, there was nothing to put back. They were completely independent things. It's not like you stole a red sector or something. So in this case, you're not going to replace stuff. Notice it's one big gaggle of cards. It's not two separate decks of cards. It's one gaggle of cards. So you've got to pick a single card, keep it out, put it in your pocket, and then pick out a second card. Notice that the card you take out the first time is going to affect the card you get the second time. I hope you understand that. All right, and the way we say that mathematically is the probability of A, then B, is you take the probability of A, the first thing you do, times the probability of B, and this bar here means given that. Given that, you already used up an A. So if you already got an A on the first event, that's going to change what happens the second draw. Let's have a look at what the heck that means. Engage. All right, so let's do that. The first event affects the second event. That would be a dependent thing. Right? If it rains, then I will not golf. So the probability of N and then a K. All right, so the probability, let's follow the formula. That's going to be the probability of N times the probability that I draw a K, given that I already used up an N. I already used up the letter card N. So there's the full formula. All right, so let's do this. All right, so let's see. The probability of an N is going to, well, there's only one N there, right? There's one N. So now I've used it up. All right, I've used up that N, so it's gone. All right, so pretend it's gone. There we go. And I better, let me move this to the front, sorry. How do I do that? I can't do that. Anyway, we already used up that card. It's not there. All right, so now we got a multiple. How many letters are left? There's only seven letters that are left. And how many of them are K's? So there's seven letters left, and there's still one K left, so it's 1 out of 7. So the answer's 1 out of 56. Notice that if the first draw there was 8 cards, on the second draw this number's going to be less than this denominator, usually by 1. Let's try it again. All right, let me get this card out of the way here. There we go. What's the probability we draw an S and then we draw an A, a single S out of this deck of cards, and then an A, given that we already used up one S. All right, so let's see. There's two S's out of 8, 1, 2, and so there was 8 cards when we first started. So now we used up one of the S's. So if we used up one of them, let's just cover it up, pretend it's not there. All right, so now we're down to 7 cards. So the denominator here is going to be 7. And how many of them are A's? Well, it looks like 3 out of the 7 are A's. So you're going to get 656. Whittle that down to 3/28. There you go. You can't reduce that anymore, right? Nice. All right, let's try Alpha. Alpha, let's unhide this card again. All right, so Alpha. What's the probability we select an R, then an S? Don't forget, we're not replacing the cards. This is a dependent event. When you don't put a card back, that changes the next draw. For one thing, you have fewer cards, and for another thing, you might have already picked the letter that you wanted. All right, so what's the probability of a red, then an S? So here's the secret formula. You calculate the probability of the R times the probability of the S, given that you already used up one of your R's. All right, so let's see. The probability of an R. I see one R. One R out of 8 cards. So I'm going to say that's a 1 out of 8 chance. And then I got to say, okay, so let's say I used up that R. Well, that means there's 7 cards left, and I want to know, let's see, what's the chance of getting an S? 1, 2. There's only 2 S's left, right? This guy's been used up. All right, so let's do that. So I'm thinking 2 out of 7. Looks like about 2 out of 56. Right, so 1 out of 28 or so. Right, you got to properly reduce these. How about Yankee? All right, see if you can follow this. Now, these get tough, these knots, because now you got to count what you're not looking for. So another way to say not is I put the bar over top, right? I like doing that, S, not. All right, so that means not S, right there, not S. So it's the probability of S times the probability that you don't get an S, although you've already taken one S. So that could change. Well, the first probability is easy. There's only two S's in there, right there. Two S's. So now you've taken out one of the S's. Let's take it out. It's not there. See, I hit it. So now we want to say, well, how many not S's are left, given that you used up this? Well, there's seven cards. Yeah, that's easy. It's always going to be one less. But how many are not S's? You might want to actually put your finger over this, right, and cover it up, right? So how many of the letters that are remaining are not S's? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? All of them except the one. I'm thinking that's what you would call 6. All right, so there you go. So I'm thinking it's 6. So you're going to get 1256, which is going to be, what's that? Can you do that? No, it's going to be 3/14. 3/14. Pretty complicated. So these get wild, right? All right, let me accelerate through India there. Here's India, because it's pretty fun. Pause it, go back, figure it out yourself. All right, now this is the one I wanted to get to, eh? The probability that you draw an A card. Well, let me reset the deck here, right? Let me unhide that. The probability you draw an A card and then a not A card. Not A, right? That means not A. All right, so that's going to be, how many of them are A's? I see 1, 2, 3 out of 8 A's. That's easy to calculate, 3 out of 8. How many of them are not A's, given that you already used up one of the A's, right? If you've already used up one of the A's, well, for sure you've only got 7 cards left. How many of them are not A's? So there's still 2 A's left. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cards left, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them are not A's, because 2 of the 7 are A's. That means 5 out of the 7 are not A's. Oh, it's a little complicated, eh? All right, so let's do that. So you get 15 out of 56. Can you reduce that? No, you can't. There, that was easy. But yes, counting what's not there is sometimes a little bit of thinking involved. All right, try it sometime. Sometimes it's easier to count what's not there, and then what's left over is the answer. And if you don't know how to do fractions, just do them on your calculator. Now, you know what? You could have done all this stuff back with the permutations and arrangements type stuff we were doing. Let me just show you that very quickly. So just as an example here, you could have done all this by going back to that basic counting method again. So let's try the first couple of these. What's the probability of not red times not red and then an A? Right, so whether you do it dependent or independent doesn't matter. Let me just show you. You could have done it with the basic counting ideas. So let's do alpha there. The probability of not red and then an A. All right, so let's see. How many possibilities were there? There was 5 possibilities there times 3 possibilities there, which means there's 15 possibilities. Now, notice when you do it with this method, they all have to be equally likely. They've all got to be equally likely, right? These sectors all have to be the same size, and these sectors have to be the same size amongst themselves. Otherwise, the secret formula for doing probabilities won't work. So there's going to be 15 different ways to come up with your spins there, right? You could have red number 1 and A, and red number 2 and A, and white number 1 and A, and white number 2 and A, and blue and A, and red number 1 and B, 1, and red number 2, and B, 1, and white number 1, and B. Do you get the idea? There's going to be 15 friggin' ways. Okay, so, yeah, you might want to, but make sure you understand that this method only works when everything's equally likely. So, the first spinner, there's 3 ways to get a not red. So, 3 ways to get a not red out of the 5 equally likely ways. The second spinner, how many ways are there to get an A? There's 1 way. All right, it's going to pop up later because I messed it up. There's how many ways to come up with an A? All right, I had to do it this way because I screwed up the numbers. All right, good thing I'm showing my work. There's 1 way to come up with an A. There's 3 ways to come up with a not red, which means there's 3 times 1 ways to come up with a not red and an A. So it's 3 out of 15 or 1 out of 5, which is exactly what we said before when we did just the probability formulas. Notice it does help if you sometimes label them, right? Because you had to make them all the same size sector, right? You could say it was red 1 and red 2 and blue 1 and blue 2. That way you know that you got the 2 blues, but by numbering them, you know that they're equally sized sectors. All right, let's try delta here. All right, you could have done it this way too. You don't have to know all the friggin' probability formulas. You could just count and do it this way. But of course, everything has to be equally likely is the only problem with doing it this way. What's the probability that it's not blue, and then a B. So not blue and a B. Well, let's see. There's still the same 15 equally likely things that could happen. So let's see. How many are not blue on the first one? How many ways are not blue? Well, I see 4 that are not blue. So the first spinner has 4 ways that are not blue. And the second spinner has how many ways that are blue, or B rather, so 4 ways that are not blue. If you count them on here, 4 ways that are not blue, 1, 2, 3, 4. They're all equally likely, so you can count them like that. Second spinner, how many ways are B's? So it looks like 2. And since there's 4 ways to spin here, and spin what you're looking for here, and there's 3 ways to spin. Correction, 2 ways to spin what you're looking for there, then that's going to be 8 ways to spin what you favor, what you're looking for, which is a not blue and a B, right? That's a B. What am I doing? 8 out of 15. All right, there you go. So I got to fix this up. What I meant to say was this is a B. So this is a not blue. Not blue. You know what I meant. Listen to what I mean, not what I say. Anyway. It turns out it does work. 4 ways, not blue. 2 ways, B. That should have been a B. I was confusing my B's and my blues. Sorry. Does that help any? Good. Anyway, there you go. Briefing is complete. Where did I go from here?